Hey, how y'all doing? Good. God is good, right?
Amen.
And all the time.
God is good.
I like to read from the Bible. And I like to read about these stories of these misfits. And so I'm going to read a story about a misfit. It's from Luke chapter 19. It says this. Jesus entered Jericho, and he was passing through. A man was there by the name of Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector, and he was wealthy. He wanted to see who Jesus was, but being a very short man, he could not because of the crowd. So he ran ahead, and he climbed into a sycamore fig tree to see him, since Jesus was coming that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and he said, "Zacchaeus, come down. I must stay at your house today." So he came down at once and welcomed him gladly. All the people saw this and began to mutter, "He's gone to be the guest of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood up and said, "Look, Lord, here and now I give away half my possessions to the poor, and if I have cheated anyone out of anything, I will pay them back four times the amount." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, for this man too is the son of Abraham, for the Son of Man has come to save and to seek what was lost." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks
be to God. The lonely chair. I want to talk to you about the lonely chair this evening. There it sits, sitting in a place of power, yet it's so scared, isn't it? Sitting there in a place of importance, the only chair up here, how special, but so very lonely, you know? Sitting in a place of wealth and luxury, it sits in the home of Zacchaeus, the chief tax collector. It's a nicer chair than this, it's the only one we could find backstage. It's Zacchaeus' chair, it's really nice, wealthy tax collector owns this chair. So you have to use your imagination a little bit. It's the end of this long table with the linens on it and like all kinds of plates and food and baskets and bread and figs and candlesticks. I mean, everything. I mean, this guy's wealthy. He's got it all, right? The floor, it's like a tile, you know, with like blues and browns. It's really sweet. And there's these tapestries on the walls everywhere. I mean, this guy lives nice, right? And then the chair. Just kind of lonely, kind of sad there looking. And there's Zacchaeus sitting there in his chair. He's kind of eating breakfast, you know. He's stuffing a fig into his mouth, right? I always see a very, very angry, bitter man, you know. Like he just got done sucking on a lemon or something, you know. I also see a guy with like one eyebrow, you know. Sorry, I didn't mean to hijack your imagination. Imagine him any way you want to. But there he sits. He sits there at the end of the long table. Zacchaeus, the tax collector, he's got like a long purple robe on, you know, and he's got like a ring on every finger and rings on his thumbs. I mean, this guy's rich, and he's like licking his fingers as he's eating his figs, you know, and he's poring over his notes there. He's got a ledger with names on it, and he's got this bag of money because, see, Zacchaeus is a tax collector. He works for them. He works for Rome. He doesn't have any friends, see? He goes from house to house, and he takes the taxes and sends them to Rome. It might be hard for you to understand what this means. Let me just kind of explain. Canada decides to invade the United States of America, and they come in, they just invade everything, they take over, you know, everything's Canadian now, right? And they hire people to go door to door and take the money from the Americans and send it to Canada. And I think that's going to be a pretty good job. So I raise my hand, and I become a Canadian tax collector, and I come to your house, and I knock on the door, and I take everything you have, and I send it to Canada. Are you going to invite me to your 4th of July picnic? No. No, this guy's a traitor. He's a traitor, and he's selfish, and he's greedy, and look at him. He's just sad and depressing. Here, you got to look deeper, though. You got to look deeper inside of Zacchaeus for a second. I'm going to open up his chest cavity and pull out his heart, and it's just disgusting, you know? It's gross. It's like black and it's like oozy. Look at that thing. It's disgusting. It doesn't beat at all and it's hard and it's dead. His heart is like, it's just sitting in there, not doing anything. You see, Zacchaeus is just kind of consumed with his own deal, you know, he's kind of consumed with himself. There's no other chair around this table. It's the only chair at the table. And he doesn't even seem to care. I mean, this guy's pathetic, man. I hate this guy, right? He's a traitor to his people. He's greedy. He's selfish. He's a big jerk. He's just sad, depressing, you know. Look at him. He's bitter and angry. I hate him. But you know what? You know what's worse than this? Is the fact that that's me. I'm Zacchaeus. You're Zacchaeus. We're Zacchaeus sitting in our little chair of me, you know, living in the land of me, all consumed with our own thing, you know. You might not be consumed with a ledger full of names and some money. Maybe you're consumed with other things like, you know, your popularity or your importance at high school or something. Maybe you're consumed with drugs and alcohol or sex or porn on the internet. Maybe you're consumed with all kinds of things about, you know, you and what you can have and what you can get and, you know, your comforts and everything about you, 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 you. That's called narcissism. You just collapse in on yourself and all you think about is yourself. It's like you walk around with a mirror all the time. You don't think of anybody else. You know, the scriptures say to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. In other words, if all you ever think about is you, if all you ever wrapped up in your own world, you are dead. You're dead. Your heart's like a little black thing in Zacchaeus' little chest cavity here. But there's a God. There's a God that loves you so much, that loves Zacchaeus so much, that loves me so much. And whispering our name, hey, Zacchaeus, Jim, Matt, Mark, Susan, Karen, Lindsay, I love you so much. I love you so much. But yet there we just sit. You know, we kind of block that out because you see, I love it up here. This is great. This is I'm like king here. This is a place of power, you know? It's like a throne. I'm like king of my own life. I could do whatever I want, right? But yet, this chair's, it's like an electric chair. It's like a throne and an electric chair at the same time. It's my death. Because to be carnally minded, to be all self-centered, is death. And so just to think about that is kind of a bummer, you know? And so Zacchaeus, just like you and me, we start to think of something else. And so he starts to look at the names of the people that owe him taxes. You know, I turn on the TV, I get on the internet, I turn on the radio, I think of something else because, you know, God forbid that I actually think about my own soul, you know? I actually think about my own life. God forbid, you know? And so there Zacchaeus sits, kind of feeding himself and feeding himself and feeding himself, but he is always hungry. He's never full. He's just feeding and feeding and feeding and feeding on TV and the internet and the radio and all this stuff. Me, 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 me. And he's hungry. He's starving. He's empty. It's not filling him up. But he tunes that out. He needs a distraction. He picks up his ledger and he picks up the gold and he starts for the door. He's going to walk out of the house. He's going to walk down the street to Jericho. He's going to collect the taxes. And he stops. He's about to walk out the door. And he sees there's like a little shelf here, you know, where he keeps all his cool little things that he steals and takes along the way. Some things he's stolen. Some things were given to him. He's got a little goblet here on the shelf. And it's given to him by his great-grandfather. It's a really cool goblet, right? And he looks at it for a moment. It's going to be Passover soon. And at Passover, see, the whole family comes together. Friends and family come together for a big party. And they drink 4 glasses of wine. The party's fun. There's people laughing and children are running around. Everybody's included. Everybody has a place at the table. But guess what? This year, no. Not Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus is not a son of Abraham. Zacchaeus is not invited. He's a sinner. He's a traitor. You wouldn't invite him. I wouldn't invite him. I would hate him. If he friended me on Facebook, I would click ignore. Not Zacchaeus. And he knows that. And so you can see his heart shrivel up even more. He's aching. He's hungry. He's longing for heaven, but he's burning in hell. And so He puts it back down. He walks out the door. He starts walking down the street, and he goes through his day. He goes to markets. He goes to homes, and he's collecting the taxes. And he's walking down the street. People don't even look him in the eye, right? They just walk right on by him. They'd kill him. They'd throw him on the ground and start stepping on his neck if they could, but they don't, because he's got a Roman guard on one shoulder and a Roman guard on the other, and they're armed to the teeth. And he walks around town with these Roman guards, and nobody touches this guy. He has so much. This guy has everything. He's got power and wealth. He's got it all. But he's dead. So he's aching and aching, and he's hungry and hungry, and he gets to this one door. He's about to knock on the door and get the taxi. He's about to knock on it, and suddenly he hears it. He hears it with his heart and with his ears. Far away, up the hill, outside of Jericho, there's a little path that comes down the hill and right into town, and there's a man running down the hill, and he's waving his arms like this, and he's going nuts, and he cries out, "Prepare the way!" And with that, Zacchaeus, he just freezes, and he turns around, and he looks up the hill, and the guy, he's running down the way, "Prepare the way! Prepare the way!" And he runs right into Jericho. "Prepare the way! It's Jesus of Nazareth! He's coming this way!" And when those words travel through the air and they reach Zacchaeus' ears, Jesus, for some reason, I don't know why, you have to ask him, but for some reason, he opens his hands and the ledger falls to the ground and the gold falls to the ground. And he turns around, and he looks, and here he comes. Up on the hill is Jesus. His whole entourage is coming this way. Everybody in town is coming out of their houses. The whole street fills with people. People coming out of their windows and out of their doors. And the whole town suddenly becomes crowded as they can't wait for Jesus to come down the hill. And Jesus comes on down the hill with a white cowboy hat, and he's got a Superman shirt. "Hey, I'm Jesus." No! No! Jesus is the love of God come to earth in the form of a person. Sacrificial love. This guy comes in, and I always hate acting like Jesus because it's hard, but he walks into town ready to give. What can he give away? And he's looking at people, he's loving on people, and he's just meeting people, but he's not alone. Here's what you got to understand. There's Matthew and James and John and Philip and Thaddeus. Thaddeus never gets a mention. I gotta mention Thaddeus. Poor Thaddeus. There's Thaddeus. He's there. And these disciples, they've been through everything. Like in a 124-hour period, these guys fed 5,000 people with a boy's lunch, went on a boat. They thought they were going to die because there was a storm. Jesus said, "Peace." It was blue sky. They land the boat. There's a naked guy. He's all crazy. Jesus says, "Demons, come out." The demons come out, go into the pigs. The pigs go down into the lake and are killed. That's one day. That's one day. So, that's one day. So the disciples are just kind of walking like this. What's going to happen today, Jesus? What are we going to do today? And the women are all behind all the guys, and the women make the ministry happen. They pay for the whole thing, and they're carrying everything, and they make it all happen. Yeah. There's Joanna and Susanna and Mary and Mary and Mary and Mary and like 85 Marys back there. But here's the deal. It's not just Jesus all by himself, like with a cape. It's all of heaven. It's the kingdom of God rolling into town. You see? You see? These people are glad to be alive, and they're glad to be with one another. It's like your little youth group coming to West Lafayette. The kingdom of God is near. The kingdom of God is near. The love of God is near, and people want to be part of that, right? Right. That's Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus wants to be part of it, and his heart is longing to be part of it, and he's been all alone for so long. He tries to see this Jesus as he's passing through. Women are holding out their babies to Jesus. Old men want their legs healed. I don't know. And Zacchaeus wants to see this guy. And so he's waving like this. And two guys look around and they see Zacchaeus wants to see Jesus. And they give him the old boom, the elbow to the face. I mean, wouldn't you? Boom! And he falls down. He dusts himself off and he sees up ahead, it's a sycamore fig tree. And Zacchaeus was a wee little man. And a wee little man was he. There's only one thing to do. Climb the tree. And so he gets up. He's got the robe and he's got the rings and everything. And he climbs up into this tree. He's never really done this before. He's kind of, and he gets out there and he squirts out onto a limb. He gets out there onto a limb. You know, sometimes you got to get out there to see Jesus, okay? Jesus is good, but it isn't always safe. You know, you could break a leg. So he's out there, and he's kind of just, he really hasn't been in a tree before. And he's kind of just, he wants to see this Jesus, and Jesus walks right underneath the tree. And he looks up, and Jesus is just delighted. Zacchaeus, he knows his name, right? Zacchaeus, come down. And so Zacchaeus kind of freezes as he realizes everybody in Jericho is staring at him. It's weird. And he tries to be cool, you know, getting down out of the tree. He gets down, he stands up, and he looks right at Jesus. And Jesus puts his arm around him, and he says, Zacchaeus, hey, I want to come stay at your house today. Can you believe this? I mean, hello? He wants to stay at it. Okay, let me just, I'm not a very political guy. I'm an independent voter, okay, so don't get me wrong. But just say, you're like really big into Obama. And so you got the bumper sticker, and you got the shirt, and you got the hat, and you got the thing, hold on, and you got the thing outside your house, and suddenly Obama comes to your town. And he's walking down the street like Obama does. And you come out of your house, and you're like, boing, boing, it's Obama. Ah! I'm your biggest fan. Obama, over here, over here, over here. And Obama walks up to Rush Limbaugh. Rush, I want to come to stay at your house. What? What? No. Jesus, me. I got the shirt. I got the hat. It says Jesus. But no, Jesus blows our minds with how much he loves. His grace just blows our minds. And he puts his arm around the most despicable person in all of Jericho. The thief, the traitor, the greedy, selfish narcissist. He puts his arm around him and says, come on, let's go stay at your house today. And everybody in town, they're like, psh, that's not Jesus. Call me when the 11:15 Jesus gets here, because it's 11 o'clock Jesus. That's the wrong Jesus. And they go back into their houses. The only people left are Jesus, Zacchaeus, and the whole entourage. And they start walking down to Zacchaeus' house. This is the part where I always wish I could be there, because it must have been blowing Zacchaeus' mind. This is how they walked, okay? And they're walking, and Zacchaeus is like, okay, the Jesus of Nazareth and all the guys and the Marys are coming over to my house. Okay, hope I have enough food. Hope I have enough napkins. Hope I have enough... Ah! I hope I have enough chairs! Oh, no, wait a second. Jesus is going to walk into my house, and he's going to see my chair. And if you've been paying attention to the drama, that's not a chair. That's Zacchaeus' sin. It's his shame. It's his loneliness. It's his narcissism. It's everything. It's just there.
And Jesus is going to walk right in and go, what? Wow, Zacchaeus, dude. Ah, that's ugly. Like, where does this go now, right? What happens? I mean, Jesus walks into your life. Jesus comes into your house, you know, into your house. Jesus comes into your house, and what does he do? He looks at your chair. He looks at all your sin and all your stuff, right? And he picks it up, and he starts to beat you with it. Come back here! Come back here! No, actually not. That was me joking. No. Here's the gospel, okay? Here's what blows my mind and should blow your mind. Jesus walks into our lives. He sees our chair. He sees our shame and our sin and all that. And he goes, okay. And he sits right down in the chair. Right? Wait, I'm not done. Then the guards put a bag over his head and they start punching him in the face. Prophesy. Who's hitting you now? Then they take off all his clothes and they take a cat of nine tails and they beat him with it. Then they put the sin, they put the shame, they put the cross on his back, and he carries the cross all the way through the streets of Jericho, Jerusalem, and he gets out into the Golgotha, the place called the skull, and they take that cross and they nail Jesus to the cross and they raise it up, and he just hangs there. He hangs there and he cries out, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. That means, my God, why have you forsaken me? And he dies. To the man on the right, they break his legs. To the man on the left, they break his legs too. But to Jesus, what they do is they take a spear, right? And they jam that spear right up into Jesus' side. And when that spear reaches into his side, and they pull it out, blood and water. Jesus is dead. But that blood, that flow, that love of God, that sacrificial love of God flowing out of Jesus' side covers over everything. It covers over our sin. It covers over our shame. And it is gone. It is... as far as, I'm like the magic guy. As far as the east is from the west, it is gone. Sin is forgiven. The love of God covers over us by the sacrifice Jesus made on the cross for us all. Right? So Zacchaeus knows that Jesus is going to see the chair. And so Zacchaeus makes sure he's the first one in the house. And so he walks into the house, and he makes a beeline to the chair, and he puts the chair in the corner, and then he stands in the corner like this, right? As everybody comes in, Jesus and Peter and James and John, they all walk in, and the first thing they see this big table full of food, right? And they all just gather around it. Hey, everybody, gather around. Gather around the table. Everybody's gathered around the table. And Jesus, I don't know, he's a carpenter. Out of nowhere comes a chair. What, I have to explain everything to you? There's a chair here. Trust me, there's chairs. Jesus takes a chair and he just slides it in. Peter, I got a chair for you. And he grabs another chair out of nowhere and he slides it right in there. One for John, and then there's one for Susanna, and there's one for Mary, and of course all the Marys. And then here's the deal. There's a chair. There's a chair. He produces a chair. And there's a chair for you. Right? There's a chair for you right at the table. And Jesus holds the chair out. And hey, come on. Come sit at the big table. It's going to be great. It's going to be a feast. Come on. And he produces all these chairs. And he puts these chairs all the way around the table. And everybody's around the table. And Peter, he's kind of hanging out with Jesus. And he's talking. And he looks over. And he sees Zacchaeus kind of standing there. Maybe this is how you feel sometimes. He's kind of standing there, and all of heaven's gathered around the table. And Zacchaeus is like, I don't know about this. And Peter goes, hey, everybody, prepare the way. Move down one. Make room for Zacchaeus. Come on, man. Jesus comes over and he grabs his chair and he slides the chair right into the table like this. And he holds out the chair for Zacchaeus. And he's like, come on, man. Come on. Zacchaeus, come on, stop. Zacchaeus in the corner. I mean, he just falls apart, right? No one has ever done this for him. Ever. He walks up to the chair, the table, the great cloud of witnesses gathered for the great feast. He puts his hand on the chair and he looks at Jesus and he says, oh, I'm so sorry. Lord, here and now I give away half I possess to the poor. And if I have cheated anyone, and he's probably cheated a few, I'll give them back four times the amount. And he sits down at the table while the whole table just erupts in applause. Peter puts his arm around him. John puts his arm, and Susanna and Mary, and they all put hands on Zacchaeus, and they pray for him. Jesus puts his hand on him, and he says, I tell you the truth. Today, salvation has come to this house. For this man, too, is a son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to save and to seek what was lost. Jesus walks over. He takes some bread. He breaks it. Body of Jesus for you. He comes over. He grabs the goblet from the shelf. He takes some wine. He pours it. And he hands it off. Zacchaeus. He takes the bread. He hadn't realized how hungry he was. He takes the cup. He hadn't realized how thirsty he was. Hungry for communion with God. Hungry for communion with the love that has created this whole universe and is here and now ready to feast with us. That's the good news of the gospel. This evening, I want to invite you to the table. There's a great banquet table at the end of days where everyone is gathered. There's a chair. It's got your name on it. It's an invitation. You don't have to take it. You don't have to sit there if you don't want to. But the gift is there. You just have to say, yeah, I like to sit there. Here's the coolest thing. Jesus is today, he's yesterday, and he's forever. That means wherever Jesus goes, this great table goes. So if Jesus is in this room, that great table is in this room. There's a chair in the kingdom of God, not just after you die, but in the kingdom of God in this very room, a chair, an invitation for you to be part of the body, to be part of the kingdom, to be part of the love of God that is here and now. Hey, I'm going to pray, and if you're hungry like Zacchaeus, my prayer is that you'll answer that invitation with a, yeah, I'll sit there. Looks comfy. Let's pray. God, we love you, and we give you thanks for how much you love us. And we pray, God, thanks for your kingdom that is all around us. We thank you for the story about Zacchaeus, which reminds us that even this loser is loved. That has to mean that I'm loved. It has to mean all of us are loved. I pray, God, that you would replace the selfishness and the narcissism in every single one of us with your love and grace. May your Holy Spirit, God, move into this place like a wildfire and ignite our hearts. Create a great forest fire that just wipes everything out and brings love and free hugs and stuff. We give you thanks in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Hey, one last thing. I'm the pastor of the Hot Metal Bridge Faith Community, which is on the south side. And we have this bar, and above the bar are these apartments. And so we're going to begin having groups come in and do mission trips to the south side of Pittsburgh. If you're interested in that, see me afterwards at the table. Also, we do a lot of dramas at our church, a bunch of dramas. And we put the dramas on a disc, but they're not video. This is better. These are scripts, the PDF files. You download them and hand them to your friends and do it for Youth Sunday. So I want to offer those resources to you guys. God bless you and have a good night.